What's up, everybody? It's your girl here, Miss Elizabeth. And guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Make sure you hit that subscription button and make sure you like this video. Give it a thumbs up kindly. And without any further ado, as you can see from my face, I'm not that happy. Like, so many things have happened, like literally this week. Okay, let's say like the first month of the year, January. It has not been an easy ilianza to poor, but it hasn't been an easy journey, and I just decided like, you're my family, like let me just come out here and address this issue, because I know as much as it affected me at some point, I know there is someone out there in a more effect in a similar way. So I decided to come out and talk to you about it, guys. Like, alert you in quotes. I just want to alert you of these people, because man, it was not a good experience, honestly. So I don't know. Okay, I think today it's on date 7 February. I don't know if I'm gonna post this video today or tomorrow. I don't know. I even don't know when I'm gonna post this video. I just felt the need of doing this video because it happened yesterday. So I feel like the wound is still fresh, you know? And I felt like this is the right moment. This is the right time to address it, you know? Yeah, so guys, as you know all, I have been in Gulf. Like, last year I was in Gulf, and you know, I finished my contract and then I came back to Kenya, and I decided like, let me just take another opportunity and just give it a try and just go and search for greener pastures, you know. So I started the process, huh? So I met, okay, this particular person that I met, I was introduced to her by my friend. You get? I was introduced to her by my friend. So we met, we even met. I don't know, you guys, there's a video, okay, I did post it here. Okay, we met on January. I don't know the exact date, but we met on January at JKIA. So this person was claiming to be a legit agent, you know, and I believe I gave her my trust because of my friend, because I was referred to her, you know. So I just took the opportunity and I said like, let's do it, you know. So I wanted to go to Dubai. Yeah, I wanted to go to Dubai, and I specifically wanted a particular job, you know. So I got the connections with the agent, and the agent says like the first statements, she said like, send me your passport, do you have a good conduct, do you have a ID, literally yellow fever. And there was like, okay, I didn't have a good contact, I didn't have a yellow fever. So I was like, give me time so that nitafute. Okay, I already applied for a good contact, so I was waiting for it to come out. So, oh my goodness, I feel so hurt even when I'm addressing this issue. I feel so hurt deep inside. But it is what it is, you know. So I went, you know. Okay, I went, nikatafuta good conduct, literally everything. And then the person said that that, you know, when you're traveling abroad, there is this particular amount that you should give out, huh? So we agreed on this particular job. I'm going to give a commission of 170,000. Okay, 170,000. And I was like, wow, okay, no problem, as long as the job is legit, you know. So I was to pay a down payment, and the down payment was 75,000. So first I wanted I siko nataka kumpea pesa before meeting her, so I was like, if your office is Ikombali, she told me that her office, she's a woman, she told me her office is Ikombasa. If I can make it to Mombasa, it's okay. But me, I was like, since I'm in Nairobi, na amesema ko flexible, ataweza kuja, we meet here in Nairobi, I was like, okay, cool. You just come, I just want to see you, and we get to talk and understand each other. You get. So, Liz, I personally, Liz, nikaenda, you know, we met at JKIA, in this particular hotel there, in a restaurant, and we talked, and by then I didn't go alone, I went with my friend. We talked, my friend. The person, even if you could listen to what she was saying, literally, I'm gonna like, she's a legit woman. Like, ata akukuwa na second thought, you know, listening from the venya naongea. But after we took a Maliza, I told my friend, like, me, I'm not feeling this woman. Like, I'm literally not. I feel like something is wrong somewhere, you know? And something that I do trust the most, I trust my instincts, you know? And I was like, yes, Suru, let's just do it. Because let me tell you something that will turn off. And I'm not saying this kumchome or anything. Like, kuna red flags zingine huwa tuna assume. Let's not assume these red flags, because if you have ever traveled abroad and umepelekwa na agencies or agent, you know how these people utajua tofauti ya agent na mtu mwenye si agent, you know. Even if you are not in a position to dress well or to dress much, like the agents that I have personally met, they are always smart. Anyone akwanga always smart, on point. But this one, like, I was like, you're claiming to be an agent, but you know. But it's something that you can't tell the person, you know, unajijazia. But I told my friend, like, I'm not feeling this person, I don't know, like I'm trying to, but I'm not, you know. But my friend was like, relax, please, you know, according to the way she's talking, she seems like she's a legit person, you know. And I was like, okay, cool. I went home, and then we agreed on a particular date, okay, that I should send the particular money. So the day came, and I sent half of the, remember, the whole commission is on 70,000. And akasema down payment inafaa kukua 75, you get. Aya, okay. Me, I don't know what I'm feeling right now, because I'm feeling so hot. I don't know, yani, I you guys. So nikamtumia 50,000. Sawa, akaniambia nitumie kwa mpesa namba yangu. Yeah, kwanza alikuwa amesema nitumie kwa Airtel number. I was like, 50,000 inakata pesa mingi sana ukituma to Airtel number. In fact, ilikuwa inakata almost 3 something. Na ni transaction, I was like, let's do Safaricom. Safaricom ilikuwa inakata 105. You know? So, the woman was like, okay, send me a Safaricom. And I was like, okay, cool. Let me tell you guys, nikatuma. No, let me take you back a little bit. Akaniambia, if you want this particular job, lazima ulipe booking fee, because ndio isichukuliwe na mtu mwingine. Sawa, akaniambia booking fee ni 10,000. So I sent her the 10,000 earlier, before even I paid this down payment, you know. Yeah, so I now let's come back. Nikamtumia 50,000. Oh my goodness. We continue communicating normally, literally everything seems just normal to me, you know? Until they come to me, okay. The 25, the nabaki, nikamwambia, I don't have money currently, but I'll get the money on this particular date. So, akangoja on that particular date, and then she started pressuring me. Yani, let me tell you, the woman alikuwa anani pressure. Literally, you can't even breathe for 2 seconds. Nitumie pesa. We want to start process. How can we start the process? How can you go for a medical without the down payment? You know, alikuwa anani pressure waka, like, I'm like, ulisikia silipia, ulisikia zitanipa, you know? Na nikamwambia, stop talking to me rudely, you know? Akaniambia, bana, we are just doing work, okay, okay, okay. Nikamwambia, okay, I'll send you the money, you know? Little did I know. Aya, on that particular date when you agreed, I'll clear the 25,000. Aya, the down payment now. Then the date came, so we agreed to meet town. So because nilimwambia siwezi kutumia pesa sahi because I'm heading to the bank, alafu nikitoka bank kufanya transactions we meet in town and then I give you the money ndo tuende medical. By the way, that particular day ndo tunaenda medical. Nikamwambia sawa, acha nitoke kwa nyumba mapema niende bank I do some transactions and then we meet wapi? To meet town hapo Kencom. In fact, aliniambia utashuka tu hapo Kencom, I'll pick you there, you know. Hadi alikuwa ananiambia na drive Prado, I don't know Prado what. Nikamwambia okay, so mimi the least that I am, you know. Nikaenda town, hiyo Equity inakuanga town. I did some transactions, nikatoa 25,000 that she wanted, you know, for the down payment, so that niende medical because she was threatening me, like, if sitalipa down payment, then there's no medical. And you know, you can't travel without medical. So me, I was like, okay, I really need this medical, you know? Wow. Let me tell you guys, kilinyaramba. I don't even try to laugh because kimeniramba. Because nikaenda Kencom. Saa tano niko Kencom. Saa sita. Saa saba. Nimesimama Kencom waiting for this woman. You know? And then the woman was like, napiga simu kwa mteja. Napiga simu kwa mteja. I was like, maybe it's network issues, my friend. Kilinyaramba. Nikakaa hapo until 4, waiting for the woman. Kilinyaramba. So I decided, like, let me go home. You know, maybe she'll call. But at the back of my mind, like, I was preparing myself. Maybe this person is a scammer, you know? Maybe this person, asha kule yo pesa, maybe she, you know? And before I even tell you, aliniambia, weka yo pesa, weka yo 25,000 kwa pesa and send it to me. Don't need to me, yeah, investor statement kwa the place that I'm going to do medical, which is kwa Westlands. You know? Hey? My guy. Kilinyaramba. Honestly. So guys, you see, man, I learned the hard way. Like, nilisimama Kencom for almost 5 hours. I felt like crying. I felt like nazisufulia. Like, I felt every feeling. Huh? Hata kupanda hiyo gari kurudi home, I was like, where am I going? Where's my money? Where will I get my money? You know? And I told my mom, you know, I told my elder brother, and all of us, we are in the process of following. Like, I told the close person, people that are close to me, I told them what happened. And currently, so right now, we are in the process of, like, kumfuatilia. Like, today I'm heading to the police station, kwa DCI. So guys, we are in that process, you know, ya kumtafuta. You know, the woman blocked me literally everywhere with the 3 numbers that she usually uses, you know. Alinipiga block, and if I try to use a new number, akijua ni Lisa na block. You know, like, I'm just crossing my fingers. Like, I want my money back, honestly, because getting that money is not an easy task. And some of you can testify that. I know to some of you it may seem like a pesa kidogo, but for me, man, it's a big deal. Like, it is a big deal for me because getting that money was not an easy task. Honestly, it wasn't. And I don't know how I trusted that woman. I don't know, but it is what it is, and it happens when you're doing lifanyika. Yeah, so right now we're in the process of following up with her because tumejaribu kumtrack, but we are still trying everything that we can. Yeah, so nimewambia, like, right now I'm heading to the DCI Kiambu. We report it there. We give every details because I have every detail. Like, niko na M-Pesa transactions, I have the money. No, I have M-Pesa transactions and I have the texts. So we are just waiting for, like, to go there to explain and we see if we can get a good advice or some help. Yeah, so I'll keep you updated. I don't know when I'll post this video, I don't know. But okay, name a drop. Just leave a comment down there. Let me know if you have ever experienced such a thing, you know? If you have ever been scammed. I don't specify, like, an agency. Let me know. Have you ever faced any scammers? Have you ever met any scammers out here? Because me, I have never. This is the first. And I guess it will be the last one. Because I'm gonna be extra careful. Even trusting people. Let me know down there. Have you ever experienced such in the comment section? Otherwise, hit that subscription button and make sure you share this video. I love you all.